me see. Okay. So today I'm going to give a short talk about tocotrienol. Initially, I was going to do a presentation about all the ingredients of Kayani Sunset. However, after looking at, tocotrienol and all its benefits and all the research that's done on this this one single ingredient in Kayani Sunset, I realized that I won't have enough time to talk about all the other ingredients. So we're just gonna focus on tocotrienol today. And essentially I wanna give y'all an overview of what tocotrienol is. It's it's a form of vitamin E, and what's the difference between tocotrienol and a more common version of vitamin E called tocopherol. And this common version of vitamin E is essentially in all your multivitamins that we purchase, like, from Costco, from vitamin stores. But why tocotrienol is superior to the commonly used tocopherol. Okay, so a brief history about tocotrienol. Vitamin E was first discovered in 1922 by two UC Berkeley anatomists called Catherine Bishop and Herbert Evans. And they noted that when animals are insufficient in alpha tocopherol, this will cause the fetus that a female animal is bearing to be resorbed, like taken up by the mother's body. So it means that if the expectant mother does not have enough vitamin E, she will actually obtain it from the fetus, and essentially, the fetus won't be able to grow. So it's initially discovered to be beneficial for fetal growth. We do not know if this happens in humans, but since the discovery of vitamin E in 1937, it was they figured out from the molecular structure of the tocopherol molecule that it has very strong antioxidant properties. And then a generation later, in 1966 or 1964, tocotrienol was discovered. And actually, in the late 1990s, there's a scientist called Dr. Barry Tan, who discovered a natural source of tocotrienol from the annatto seeds. And he made this commercially available in 2003. And subsequently, in the past decade, so from 2010 to 2020, research on tocotrienol has skyrocketed. So before that, most research was done on tocopherol. If I do a quick search on PubMed, you can show all the publications on tocotrienol. That's around 800. You can see on this slide that, here is where tocotrienol was first discovered in 1964. But it was not until the past decade, between 2010 and 2020, that over 82% of the research papers that are published was written. Okay, so let's look at the different forms of vitamin E. Vitamin E has 8 different forms, okay? As you can see here, there's the tocopherol family and the tocotrienol family, and each has 4 different forms. The first studied and most common form is alpha tocopherol, which is this form, okay? And most over-the-counter multivitamins contain this form of vitamin E. Apart from being known as a fertility factor and possessing antioxidant properties, since research on tocotrienols has increased, it is quickly obvious that alpha tocopherol is actually not as potent as tocotrienol, even in its antioxidant property. So if you look at this bar graph here, you can see that actually gamma and delta tocotrienol, the red bars here, they are 5 times more the levels of the LORAC, which measures oxygen radical absorbance capacity, so the antioxidant level of these components, is 5 times more than alpha tocopherol. So why is that? Let's look at its chemical structure to figure out why. Okay, so both tocopherols and tocotrienols have this chromanol head. Okay, so they both have the chromanol head, but tocopherols have a saturated fatty acid tail, while tocotrienols have an unsaturated fatty acid tail. So when it's unsaturated, it has these double bonds, okay? And then the various forms, alpha, beta, gamma, and delta, they are distinguished by where the methyl group is placed on the chromanol head. So R1, R2, and R3 are different positions that the methyl group can be placed on. And the alpha form, alpha tocopherol and alpha tocotrienol, has methyl groups in all three positions, okay? This results in a larger head group, which reduces the access of the phenolic head to oxidized lipid. Therefore, a tocotrienol or tocopherol that has less methyl groups is actually going to be more potent in its antioxidant property. Okay, that's why gamma and delta forms are more potent. Furthermore, tocotrienol has a shortened tail compared to tocopherol because of the unsaturated fatty acid tail. So the saturated tail of tocopherol makes it longer and stiffer, and so it's less mobile in lipid membranes, as the tail will anchor in the membrane, while tocotrienol has a shorter tail and it's more flexible because it's unsaturated, which allows it to move more freely within the phospholipid membrane. Because it moves more freely, it's actually more active than tocopherols, allowing it to have greater mobility in biomembranes, traveling much faster, around 50 times faster than tocopherol. And this allows it to arrest lipid radicals from further oxidation in the lipid membranes. But you might ask, why is it important to have a strong antioxidant like tocotrienol that is lipid soluble? Well, I don't know if you know this, but the human body is made up of approximately 38 trillion cells. All of these cells are formed by biolipid membranes. So you can imagine how much lipid membranes we have in our body. Now, these biolipids can get easily oxidized by free radicals from the environment, right? The air that we breathe in, pollution, ingested through food, like with all the chemicals that are in the soil and fertilizers and all the insecticides, right? So we need serious antioxidant protection for our phospholipid membranes. And vitamin E, either in the tocopherol or tocotrienol forms, would best play a protective role for our vast phospholipid membranes. But on top of being a strong antioxidant, tocotrienol has a lot of other unique functions. It has anti-cancer, anti-diabetes abilities, as well as cardio, neuro, liver, and bone protective actions based on their unique functions in the body. So let's first look at the cardioprotective effects of tocotrienol. One of the leading causes of death in US is cardiovascular disease. Tocotrienols has many cardioprotective effects that can help us fight against cardiovascular disease. So let's look at some of these. We all know that the heart is one of the most important organs in our body. It works ceaselessly, beating 100,000 times a day, 40 million times a year, and in total clocking up almost 3 billion heartbeats over an average lifetime. So it's very important for us to supply it with the necessary oxygen to keep it going. I was actually first introduced to cardiovascular disease when my father had his first heart attack when I was in elementary school. That was the first time, I mean, at such a young age, that I learned that heart attacks can be caused by blocked arteries that supply oxygen to the heart. And this, in turn, is due to high cholesterol. Well, the production of cholesterol in our bodies is actually dependent on an enzyme called HMG-CoA reductase. This enzyme is targeted by cholesterol-lowering drugs that are typically known as statins. Okay, they work by inhibiting this enzyme. Now, the interesting thing is tocotrienol can also target this enzyme. And it does so by either lowering the production of this enzyme or inhibiting it. When you have less HMG-CoA reductase, that is equivalent to less cholesterol production. The only difference between tocotrienols and statin drugs are that these drugs come with side effects, like it can cause diabetes or liver damage. Now, another interesting fact that I found is some studies have shown that the cholesterol-lowering function of tocotrienol can actually be interfered by the presence of tocopherol, which is the saturated form of vitamin E that I talked about earlier. Now, these findings emphasize the importance of taking a pure source of tocotrienol without any tocopherol contamination. Okay, I'm sure you guys all know that high LDL, which is the bad cholesterol, low density lipoprotein, leads to plaque formation in coronary arteries. Recently, research also showed that oxidized LDLs is actually a risk factor for plaque formation. Now, oxidized LDL is LDL that's oxidized by reactive oxygen species. And these oxidized LDL can be taken up by macrophages. And if the macrophages are overloaded with the oxidized LDL, they will convert to foam cells. When they convert to foam cells, they recruit monocytes that adhere to the walls of the arteries and start forming the plaque with fatty LDL deposits. Well, how can tocotrienol help in this situation? Research shows that delta tocotrienol is the most effective in inhibiting lipid peroxidation, and so it can protect LDL from getting oxidized. Not only that, tocotrienols are also found to reduce monocyte cell adhesion molecules, and this dramatically reduces the Velcro effect of circulating monocytes on the arterial wall. So it prevents the monocytes from sticking easily to the walls of the artery. A lesser known cause of cardiovascular disease is chronic inflammation. Now, chronic inflammation is a natural consequence of aging, but it is more significantly present in patients with a history of cardiovascular disease, type 2 diabetes, cancer, or stroke. And chronic inflammation is manifested by elevated levels of two inflammation markers, interleukin-6 and C-reactive protein. Tocotrienols have been shown to effectively lower C-reactive protein levels in blood serum, and it is 20 to 50 times more effective than tocopherols in doing this. Okay, so in the interest of time, I'm only presenting a few ways that tocotrienol can protect us from cardiovascular disease. In fact, if you do a quick search on PubMed, there are over 100 research papers published on this topic. And in the short 20 minutes that I have, I don't think I can cover all of that. So I can just highlight a few of the significant ones. Okay, the second leading cause of death in US is cancer. The American Cancer Society predicts that in 2020, in the United States alone, 1.8 million new cancer cases and over 600,000 cancer deaths will occur. So let's take a look at what tocotrienol can do to help our body fight cancer. There's been studies on cancer cells in petri dishes, in animal models, and even some clinical trials that show tocotrienol is effective against lung cancer, colon, liver, breast, pancreatic, prostate, brain, ovarian, and myeloma cancer. So in fact, there was an impressive study where researchers found that tocotrienol, when it's given to mice that carry aggressive pancreatic cancer, actually have significant survival rates, improved survival rates. So in the control group, the animals that are not given tocotrienol, only 10% of them survive within the study period of 16 weeks, while 70% of those that take tocotrienol survived. So this is a very significant result because we know that pancreatic cancer is a particularly fast-moving and lethal form of cancer. And so this study presents a promising new treatment option. So how does tocotrienol prevent cancer? It does so by inducing programmed cell death in cancer cells, which leads to tumor cell death. It also prevents cell division, and that helps to slow tumor growth. It inhibits the formation of new blood vessels, which causes the tumor to starve of nutrients and oxygen. It also inhibits HMG-CoA reductase. Remember this enzyme that produces cholesterol? Well, this enzyme is also implicated in cancer metastasis. So by inhibiting this enzyme, it prevents the cancer from metastasizing. Tocotrienol can also decrease the expression of cancer-causing genes, which prevents the initiation of cancer. And lastly, it can increase the expression of cancer-suppressing genes, which prevents the initiation and progression of cancer. Well, what about other health benefits? To name a few, there's diabetes. So tocotrienols have been found to improve blood sugar and kidney function in diabetic animals and improve insulin sensitivity. And also in non-alcoholic fatty liver disease, or NAFLD, we know that in this disease, fat is deposited in the liver, and that can cause hepatitis, liver failure, or even cancer. There's been studies in a randomized clinical trial, 87 adults with high cholesterol and NAFLD received mixed tocotrienols or a placebo. And after 1 year, these patients that were supplemented with tocotrienol or the placebo were, they did an ultrasound on their liver tissue. And the group of patients that were given tocotrienols had a significantly greater rate of normalization of their liver tissue compared to the control patients. Another study showed that oral tocotrienols can delay the progression of end-stage liver disease in 50% of liver transplant patients, compared with just 20% in a group treated with alpha-tocopherol. The study demonstrated good tissue penetration of oral tocotrienols in humans, countering previous reports that there was poor bioavailability of this molecule. So that's pretty significant, and all these studies were done on in humans. So what about neuroprotection? Oxidation, inflammation, and toxicity resulting from normal brain cell activity are all involved in the terrifying progression of cognitive decline. That is why strong antioxidants are so important, especially lipid-soluble ones like tocotrienol, because your brain is mainly made up of fat. Okay, so there's a study where patients with Alzheimer's disease or those with mild cognitive impairment, they show that in their blood are more likely than healthy people to have low blood tocopherol and tocotrienol levels. So conversely, okay, some old people that contain high levels of tocotrienols in their blood have shown to have a 64% reduced risk of having Alzheimer's. So animal studies also demonstrate protection from free radical-induced brain cell death in rats. And in fact, it also reduced DNA damage in brain cells. What about bone health? Tocotrienols can prevent and even reverse bone loss and promote fracture healing in animal models of osteoporosis from many different causes. So menopause can cause osteoporosis. A steroid treatment can also cause osteoporosis. But how does tocotrienol do that? We know that it's a potent antioxidant, and it appears to reduce the oxidant-induced inflammation that contributes to bone loss. And tocotrienol has also been shown to upregulate genes related to new bone formation. And as we know, tocotrienol inhibits this important enzyme HMG-CoA reductase. And HMG-CoA reductase is actually found to be profoundly involved in osteoporosis because it favors bone-resorbing cells that means causing bone to be worn out, or over bone forming ones. So it favors bone resorbing cells over bone forming ones. So it prevents bone forming. By inhibiting HMG-CoA reductase, tocotrienols can actually prevent excessive bone resorption or bone breakdown and promote new bone formation. Okay, so this is just a short overview of all the health benefits of tocotrienol. After discussing all these important health benefits, I hope that you realize how important it is to have tocotrienol in our bodies. Unfortunately, tocotrienol is not naturally produced by our body, so we can only ingest it from food. But our average daily diet provides less than 10 milligrams per day of tocotrienol. Studies have shown that we need around 100 to 200 milligrams of tocotrienol per day to enjoy its health benefits. So supplementation is necessary. Furthermore, the purity of our tocotrienol supplement is very important as well, because we have, I've mentioned earlier, and also there's many other studies that have shown that the presence of alpha tocopherol in mixtures leads to decreased efficacy of tocotrienol. In fact, many papers have emerged in the past decade from test tube, animal to human trials, showing that alpha tocopherol puts brakes on the function of tocotrienol. And as you can see from this figure, annatto tocotrienol is the purest source of tocotrienol. It is actually made up of 90% delta and 10% gamma tocotrienol, whereas palm and rice have 25 to 50% of tocopherol contamination, which could dampen the beneficial effects of tocotrienol in these two sources. Now, the more I study the ingredients used to formulate our Kayani Triangle of Health, the more I appreciate how Kayani has selected the highest quality of each vitamin and mineral source and perfectly combined the water-soluble ones into sunrise and the lipid soluble ones into sunset, and then paired each of these with the nutrient absorption enhancer Nitro FX or Nitro Extreme to give us this complete spectrum of nutritional building blocks that we need for healthy living. Now, the sunset contains a pure source of delta and gamma tocotrienol from annatto seeds. Like I mentioned earlier, it's a pure form. There's no tocopherol contamination. Delta and gamma tocotrienols are the most potent forms of vitamin E, with lots of health benefits just by itself. But because it is such a strong lipid antioxidant, it actually also helps to maintain the integrity of the omega-3 fatty acids sourced from wild Alaskan sockeye salmon that is found in Kayani Sunset. So it prevents the lipid peroxidation of these omega fatty acids. Now, why is that important? Oxidized polyunsaturated fatty acids like omega-3 fatty acids are not only useless to the body, they can even be harmful because they can cause oxidative stress in our bodies. Therefore, it's very important for the omega fatty acids to be protected from oxidation. And by combining tocotrienols with omega-3 fatty acids, Kayani is actually killing two birds with one stone. So in combination with additional excellent ingredients like beta-carotene, vitamin D, and astaxanthin, all lipid-soluble ingredients, it is no surprise that Kayani Sunset was granted the highest quality award from Mons Selection, their Grand Gold Award, both in 2015 and 2018. So with that, I'm gonna end my presentation and hope that everyone is able to learn a little bit more about tocotrienol today.
Thank you, Dr. Gray, for your thoughtful and thorough presentation on tocotrienol and for your educating all of us about how this fantastic beneficial properties of tocotrienol. I don't know about you, but after hearing Dr. Grace's presentation, I feel like even more impressed and appreciative of for how thoughtful Kayani's products are, how they're formulated. Learning about the quality, uniqueness, and superiority of our product is very important. But Kyani offers us more than just good products, right? Kyani offers us an incredible business opportunity. And so come back next week where we will share more about the compensation plan and how you can get your Kyani business going. So thank you so much for your time, and stay tuned for the next portion, the Chinese portion of the meeting. For the English-speaking group, Natsuko, Joanna, if you want to stay on. See you next week. Thank you. Bye-bye. Grace, 你要喝点水. That's great.
我喝点下一场会很慢哦。
没有关系，我们这英文可以早点结束。 大家知道这Grace的中文呢 比他英文非常烂，只是差，还可以有待进步。所以不过他很勇敢，他这小姐蔡博士这个星期花了很多心血把这个英文版然后翻成中文版，然后讲的练习了很久，所以因为。 你们刚刚听过英文版，所以我们现在听中文版再听，更深入的学习。 Oh, hi, Maria. Sorry, English is finished. I'll send you the recording. So sorry. your speaker is off. Microphone is off. But anyway, 所以大家谢谢这个 Dr. Grace 刚刚讲我们介绍这个 Vitamin E 哦，它的好处啊，为什么。 在我们这个产品里头，所以还是很快再讲一遍。然后再讲之前呢，我让他先休息，呼吸，休息一口气啊。我要跟大家讲一下哦，Joanna小姐不在了。Joanna小姐呢，在昨天我跟她报告她一个好消息，她在昨天签了两个合作伙伴。那这两个合作伙伴是美国买最大 package 1999那个 package， which is incredible，OK？所以很多人说。 现在疫情，现在经济不好，等等等等，一大堆这些。但是 ，there's still people， 还是有合作伙伴，还是有人很注重这个生意机会，所以不要被这些所谓的问题成为你的绊脚石。如果你很相信你可以做到的话，你可以达到的。那我们这 Joanna 小姐就是很棒的例子，所以下个星期他们跟我分享一下她怎么去。 去分享凯亚迪的产品，如何去吸引这两个新的合作伙伴，用这个1999元全景来。所以，下个星期他会讲一点。那现在我们请我们的蔡博士继续的跟我们分享我们的维他命E油，好不好？哦，维他命E，谢谢。Okay, ready? You got this, girl.
看到吗？看到，很好，谢谢。好，你的
notes is on too.
So, great. 大家好，今天我将总结一下我对生育三七分的了解，那也讲一下为什么凯亚尼把生育三七分加在新书康里面。 还有生育三七分跟常见的生育分有什么区别？那大家都知道我的中文水平是很低的，所以如果我讲错了发音或者什么的话，请大家多多的原谅。而且我那个这个 PPT 我可以跟大家分享，那我有那个中文的笔记在下面。那如果 你们听不懂，等一下就可以自己看哈。好，那我们就开始。谢谢。那维生素 E 呢，是由两位加州大学伯克利分校的解剖学家 Catherine Bishop 跟 Herbert Evan， 在1922年首次发掘的。 那他们指出呢，动物体内的 alpha 生育分不足的时候，会导致 胎儿被母体吸收。那因此呢，如果准妈妈没有足够的 维生素E， 它将从胎儿那里获取。 那我们不知道这种情况是否会在人类中发生，但是自从在1937年发现生育酚的分子结构以后呢，它的抗氧化特性很快就被发掘了。那1964年的时候，科学家就发现了生育三烯酚，可是不到1990年代后一个科学家叫Barry Tan 博士，他是找出从胭脂树种子中发现了有生育三烯酚的天然来源，并在2003年给它投入市场。那在过去这十年中呢，有关生育三烯酚的研究就如雨后春笋般的发展起来。那如果在 PubMed 上进行一个搜索会显示呢，虽然生育三烯酚在1960年代被发现但有关于生育三烯酚的研究论文中有 80% 以上是在最近十年才发表的。好，我们来看一看生育维生素 E 的不同形式。那维生素 E 有八种形式哈，还有那个生育酚有四种，生育三烯酚也有四种，就是 alpha、beta、gamma 跟 delta。那首先最常见的形式呢，就是 alpha 的生育酚。那大多数商店购买的维生素都包含这种形式的维生素 E， 除了被称为生育因子并具有抗氧化特性以外呢，其实 alpha 生育酚的抗氧化能力比生育三烯酚弱。那事实上呢，如果你看这个图表，你会看到 gamma 跟 delta 生育三烯酚的 LORAC 就是氧自由基吸收能力呢的水平是 alpha 生育酚的五倍。那这是为什么呢？我们需要看它们的结构加益来找出原因。好，生育酚和生育三烯酚都具有这个苯甲酚头，苯甲酚头就是这两个哈。那生育酚呢，它有饱和的脂肪酸尾巴，饱和就是没有双键的生育酚。那生育三烯酚呢，它有不饱和的脂肪酸尾巴，就是有双键的的尾巴。那 alpha beta 跟 gamma 和 delta 的各种形式的不同之处在于，甲基在苯甲酚头中的位置，那它有三个不同的位置。Alpha 形式是具有三个甲一 ，OK， 哦，对不起，它有三个甲一，那导致呢它的头就比较大，而从而会降低它的酚醛头与氧化脂质的接触，所以它的抗氧化能力会比其他维他命 E 的形式低。此外呢，与生育三烯酚跟生育酚相比呢，生育三烯酚的尾巴是比较短的。那我们看，那生育酚的饱和尾巴比生育三烯酚更长，还有更硬。你看到这个它的尾巴，看不到我的 cursor。 对，它尾巴比较长跟比较硬，因此呢，生育酚在脂质膜中的流动性比较小，因为它的尾巴将它锚定在膜中。那生育三烯酚的尾巴呢是比较短，它也比较柔韧，柔韧性更好，因为它是不饱和的，它有双键的，因此呢，它可以在膜内更自由的移动。那它比生育酚具有更高的活性，移动速度也比生育酚快50倍，可以阻止脂质自由基进一步的氧化。但是你可能会问，为什么拥有强的脂溶性抗氧化剂如此的重要呢？如果你看我们的人体，我们的人体是由大约38万亿个细胞组成的，那这些细胞呢都是由生物脂膜形成的。我们呼吸空气中的污染啊，或从食物摄取的自由基，很容易的氧化这些生物脂质。那这就是为什么我们需要脂溶性的抗氧化剂来保护我们的细胞组织。可是生育三烯酚呢，除了具有强大的抗氧化功能以外，它还具有许多其他独特的功能，例如抗癌、抗糖尿病能力，以及对人体的心脏、神经、肝脏和骨骼都有保护的作用。那在美国呢，死亡的主要原因之一是心血管疾病。那生育三烯酚具有许多心脏保护的作用，可以帮助我们对抗心血管疾病。那让我们来看一下其中一些功能。大家都知道，心脏是我们体内最重要的器官之一。它持续不断的工作，每天跳动大约10万次，一年可以跳动4000万次。那平均的寿命呢，可以达到30亿次的跳动。那因此呢，为心脏提供足够的氧气是非常重要的。我在小学1、2年级呢，已经知道什么是心血管疾病，因为我那个时候我爸爸是第一次心脏病发作。那在这么小的年纪呢，我已经知道心脏病发作是因为心血管被阻塞，而高胆固醇会导致动脉阻塞。那胆固醇呢是由我们体内的一种酶叫做 HMG-CoA reductase 产生的。常见的降胆固醇药物呢会抑制这种酶。那生育三烯酚也可以通过减少或抑制来控制 HMG-CoA reductase。它可以减少 HMG-CoA reductase，就等于减少胆固醇的生产的产生。那生育三烯酚和降低胆固醇的药物之间有什么区别呢？唯一的区别是这些药物有糖尿病啊和肝损害的副作用。那其实有一些研究表明哦，生育酚不单没有降胆固醇的作用，它还会干扰生育三烯酚的胆固醇降低功能。因此呢，我们吃纯净的生育三烯酚是非常重要的，因为生育酚会负面的影响生育三烯酚的功能。那我知道大家可能应该知道低密度脂蛋白也称为 LDL 的含量高的时候呢，会导致冠状动脉斑块形成。那最近呢，研究表明氧化的 LDL 呢是形成斑块的危险因素之一。 那当 LDL 被氧化的时候，它可以被巨噬细胞吸收。如果巨噬细胞包含的氧化 LDL 过多呢，它们会转化成泡沫细胞。那这些泡沫细胞会吸引单核细胞那单核细胞来到那个那个气管呢，就会粘在动脉壁上并形成斑块。那么生育三烯酚在这种情况下如何提供帮助呢？研究表明 Delta 生育三烯酚是一种强大的脂质抗氧化剂，因此它可以保护 LDL 免受氧化。不仅如此，生育三烯酚还可以减少单核细胞的粘附分子从而可以防止单核细胞粘附在动脉壁上，从而可以防止斑块的形成。那心血管疾病的一个鲜为人知的原因是慢性炎症。慢性炎症呢是一个衰老的自然结果。但在有心血管疾病或者糖尿病或者癌症或者中风病史的患者中这个会比较明显，这个慢性的炎症。慢性炎症导致两种炎症标记物白介素6也是英文是 interleukin 6和 C 反应蛋白的水平升高。那生育三烯酚可以降低血清中的 C 反应蛋白水平，那它的结果是比生育酚高达20%到50%。那为了节省时间我只能介绍几种方法，生育三烯酚怎么帮助我们的心脏保护我们的心脏关于这个主题的研究论文其实是超过100篇。那在短短的20分钟内我就只能强调一些重要的发现。在美国第二大死亡原因是癌症。那美国癌症协会预测在2020年将有180万例新癌症病例还有超过60万例癌症死亡。那让我们看一看生育三烯酚可以做什么来帮助我们对抗癌症。在实验室动物模型甚至某些临床试验中对癌细胞的研究表明，生育三烯酚可以有效治疗肺癌结肠癌、肝癌、乳腺癌、胰腺癌、前列腺癌、脑癌、卵巢癌、骨髓瘤等等。实际上呢，有一项令人印象深刻的研究那研究人员呢给患有侵袭性胰腺癌的小老鼠服用生育三烯酚那这些老鼠呢服用了生育三烯酚呢，它可以存活更长的时间对照组中只有10%的小老鼠在研究期内就是16周可以存活而服用生育三烯酚的小老鼠中呢有70%可以存活，这是很惊讶的结果。那胰腺癌我们都知道是一种特别快速和致命的癌症，那这项研究提出了一种有希望的新治疗方案。那么生育三烯酚呢如何预防癌症呢？它可以诱导癌细胞程序性的死亡。 它可以防止细胞分裂，减慢肿瘤的生长，它也可以抑制心血管的形成，以防止营养和氧气进入肿瘤。那它也抑制HMG CoA reductase 酶乙组织阻止癌症的转移。它可以减少致癌基因的表达，从而促进癌症的发生，阻止癌症的发生。那最后呢，它通过增加抑制癌基因的表达，来预防癌症的发生和发展。好，那么其他的健康益处呢？我们来谈一谈糖尿病吧。一些研究论文表明，生育三烯酚在糖尿病的动物模型中可以改善血糖和肾脏的功能，它并可以改善胰岛素的敏感性。那在非酒精性的脂肪肝疾病呢，当脂肪沉积在肝脏中，它会导致肝炎、肝衰竭，甚至癌症。那在一项随机临床试验中，高胆固醇和非酒精性脂肪肝疾病的87位成人接受了生育三烯酚或安慰剂的补充。一年后呢，接受了生育三烯酚补充治疗的患者，在超声检查中，他的肝脏组织的正常化率明显的高于对照组。那另一项研究表明呢，口服生育三烯酚可延迟 50% 的肝移植患者的终末期肝病进展，而接受 alpha 生育酚治疗的一组只有 20% 有同样的效果。那这项研究呢，也证明了口服生育三烯酚在人体中具有良好的组织渗透性。那神经保护呢，正常的脑细胞活动的时候，它会导致氧化、炎症和毒性的发生，而这些呢，都与认知能力下降的可怕进展有关。那这就是为什么强抗氧化剂如此的重要，尤其是脂溶性抗氧化剂，例如生育三烯酚。那研究表明，阿尔茨海默氏病的病患者和轻度认知障碍患者的血液呢，可以发觉他的血液中的生育酚和生育三烯酚水平是低于正常人的。相反呢，在一些非常老的人呢，如果他的血液中生育三烯酚含量比较高呢，那他患阿尔茨海默氏病的风险就会降低到 64%。还有许多其他研究也表明，生育三烯酚能够保护大脑免受 DNA 损伤和神经毒素的侵害。好，最后我们谈到骨骼健康。那不知道您是否知道，更年期和慢性类固醇治疗会促进骨质流失。那在骨质疏松症的动物模型中，生育三烯酚可以预防甚至逆转骨质流失，并促进骨折愈合。那它是如何做到的呢？由于生育三烯酚是有效的抗氧化剂，因此它可以减少 氧化剂引起的炎症，那炎症会导致骨质流失，减少炎症就会减少骨质流失。那生育三烯酚还可以上调与心骨形成有关的基因。我们之前也提到过，生育三烯酚会抑制 HMG CoA reductase 酶。但是您知道 HMG CoA reductase 酶也与骨质疏松症有关。它可以促进骨吸收细胞，而不是骨形成细胞。那通过抑制 HMG CoA reductase 酶呢，生育三烯酚就可以防止过度的骨吸收，并帮助新的骨形成。好，讨论了生育三烯酚的健康益处后，我希望大家都可以发现到生育三烯酚在我们体内的重要性。那不幸的是，我们体内我们身体是无法自然产生生育三烯酚，我们只能从食物上摄取。但是呢，我们日常饮食中的生育三烯酚含量是很少的，通常从我们的饮食中摄取最多10mg 一天的生育三烯酚。那研究论文表明，要体验生育三烯酚健康的益处，我们每天需要服用100-200mg 的生育三烯酚，因此呢，补充是必要的。可是找到纯净的生育三烯酚来源是非常重要的，因为如果来源有 alpha 生育酚的污染，会导致生育三烯酚的功效降低。实际上，在过去的10年中，从试管动物到人体试验，已经出现了许多论文表明 alpha 生育酚酚可以在许多情况下抑制生育三烯酚的功能。那在这里呢，我们看到了生育三烯酚的三大自然来源。胭脂树种子里面的生育三烯酚呢是最纯净的。它由 90% 的 delta 和 10% 的 gamma 生育三烯酚组成。另外两种天然来源呢，棕榈和大米中有25%-50%的生育酚污染，那这将会大大的降低他们的生育三烯酚的效率。那我对凯阿尼的健康金三角里面的成分进行越多的研究呢，我就越欣赏凯阿尼如何精心挑选每种维生素和矿物质的最高质量。此外呢，他们将水溶性维生素和抗氧化剂完美的融合成辛勒斯，而将脂溶性的 omega-3 脂肪酸脂溶性的维生素和抗氧化剂完美的结合成新舒康，并与营养吸收促进剂的尼多乐和尼致乐配合，为我们提供了健康生活所需的完整营养。那新舒康含有的维他命 E 呢，是来自胭脂树种子里面的 delta 和 gamma 生育三烯酚，那是最纯净的来源。那 delta 跟 gamma 的生育三烯酚是最有效的维生素 E 形式，那本身具有很多健康的益处，但是由于它是一种强大的脂质抗氧化剂，因此它也可以帮助防止新舒康中的 omega-3 脂肪酸氧化。那 omega-3 脂肪酸如果被氧化呢，这不仅对身体无用，甚至可能有害。那因此呢，保护这些 omega-3 脂肪酸免受氧化是非常重要的。 那凯亚，你在新书刊中添加了生育三十分，其实是一箭双雕。凯亚，你把阿拉斯加的野生红鲑鱼的纯正的 omega-3 脂肪酸和生育三烯酚以及 beta 胡萝卜素还有维生素 D 和虾精素等等的优良成分结合在新书刊里面。难怪呢，新书刊在2015年和2018年可以两次获得 Mon Selection 的最高质量奖。好，那我在这里就结束我的分享，希望大家还听得懂。那我刚刚所说的一切，如果觉得我发音有什么错误呢，请大大原谅。然后谢谢大家的聆听。